Today marks the first day of my fall semester. Although, it's not really going to feel that way because I actually don't have any class meetings. All my classes are on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday this semester, with additional online work to do throughout the week. I took some time on summer break to really reflect over my freshman year, which I found to be very beneficial. Through the successes, failures, and experiences that took place, I definitely learned a lot, which has me going into this semester with more confidence. After reflecting, I created a list of the top 5 key lessons I learned from those first 2 semesters, and that is what I will be sharing with you today. The first key lesson I want to go over from my freshman year is that my perspective and my intentions became my experience. They were my experience at the end of it. So what does that mean? Well, first I do want to say that I went into freshman year with a firm perspective and bold intentions. I was believing that it was going to be the best season of my life, that I was going to build new great relationships with an intentionality behind it, that I was going to find a community of people who I could grow with, that I was going to live more purposefully, spend my time more intentionally, that I was going to grow in multiple areas of my life. And all that pretty much came true. I took action behind my perspectives and what my intentions were, and that all came true. So I found my identity. I was constantly learning. I built lifelong friendships. I got a paid internship. I found a community of dudes that fueled my growth, and I went on mental, physical, and spiritual adventures that led to excitement, joy, and peace. So I really believe that because of my perspective and because of my intention going into it, those things came to life. I took action for those things to come to life. And the last thing I really want to say about this right now, to add some context with the current situation of the world, in the midst of a pandemic, whatever your COVID-19 situation looks like, I know a lot of people have a negative perspective. They think it sucks. They think this is a horrible situation, which is not the best situation. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying if that's your viewpoint, if that's what you think about this going into it, that, you know, this is gonna suck, then it's gonna suck. And if you don't think that, you know people around you that are thinking like that and that are probably voicing it. So don't let that rub off on you. Don't agree with them because just because. I don't want you to have a bad experience in a situation or an experience that sucks because you went along with following someone else's perspective. So think about what you want going into it and how you're gonna be intentional behind that. And as long as that's followed up with action, I believe that that will be your experience. So that's my first point. I'm gonna get into the second here soon. I got a couple things to do real quick, and then we'll keep it rolling. Second key takeaway I want to give you from my first year of college is that time management starts with discipline. I could almost word it as time management is discipline. Self-discipline is not motivation, and you do not need motivation to manage your time better. I found this out pretty quickly because I went into freshman year very motivated, and I thought that this motivation, if I could keep it up, and this drive would allow me to be able to manage my time well. But I realized that I needed to be disciplined. And if you're not too sure what discipline is, and even if you are, I think this quote that I found will be very helpful and will add some good value to this idea of discipline. So it says, self-discipline is about leaning into resistance, taking action in spite of how you feel, living a life by design, not by default. But most importantly, it's acting in accordance with your thoughts, not your feelings. So the main two things I get from that quote, and in retrospect that I got from my freshman year in terms of time management, is that you have to defeat the I don't feel like it thoughts. You're not always going to feel like doing something that you need to do. So being able to defeat the I don't feel like it thoughts and do something anyway is huge. And then the other thing I got is that You need to intentionally create your days instead of going with the flow. It's so easy to go with the flow. It's very comfortable to go with the flow. And that's kind of living the life by default, but living a life by design and intentionally creating your days and following through with that is gonna build that self-discipline. And I think the last thing I can throw in there is to replace some of your bad habits with good habits. I think it's easier to defeat a bad habit when you're replacing it intentionally with a good habit. And I think that'll also lead to being more disciplined, which will also lead to managing your time better. So think about those things. That's my main thing for number two, is that time management starts with discipline, and it basically is discipline. But I think I'm just gonna go ahead and hop into point number three right now, give you that, continue on with my day, and then give you four and five after. Number three is to embrace discomfort. None of the growth I experienced came from a place of being comfortable. I can't imagine how boring and bland my first year would have been if I would have shied away from discomfort, if I would have stayed in my comfort zone. I think every great thing that happened came from a place of me stepping outside of my comfort zone. Whatever it is, succeeding in the classroom, finding the right community, securing the internship, pursuing the passion, whatever else you're going for with your first year or whatever year you are, I don't think any of it's gonna happen from a place of being comfortable. If you're desiring discomfort, you're embracing it, you're stepping out of your comfort zone regularly to pursue things, then I think you're gonna have a great year. I think that's gonna be such a huge thing to keep in mind. So think about that. That's point number three. So we got three of five right now. Don't click off the video yet. Please watch it to the end, because these next two are huge. Number four is a very, very practical takeaway that if you use, it's gonna help you a ton, because it helped me a ton. And then number five is my favorite, which impacted me the most, I would say. Stick around, I'm gonna continue on with my day, and then I'm gonna get to those for you and we'll wrap it up. All right, let's go.
Okay, go, go, go. She always be talking like she know, know, know. I told her don't ever leave me long, long, long. I guess I'm accident, run, 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 run.
Out here chilling on this hammock that I found in the area around my apartments. Just got back from campus, but I'm gonna go ahead and give you key takeaway number four right here, and that is to take advantage of university resources. Right now I'm currently taking advantage of apartment complexes resources, but seriously, last year I'm so glad that I took advantage and took initiative to check out and try and take advantage of the resources that NKU offers. There's a lot. All universities have a ton of free services and resources that you should check out. Me personally, some have saved me from doing poorly in a class. Others have led to some amazing connections, and one has even led to an amazing internship experience. So there's a variety of stuff, some obvious, some not so obvious. Definitely look into it. There's IT services, computer labs, great study spots, recreational services, health services, tutoring services, professors' office hours. That's a big one. That's good. There's so much more that I'm not gonna be able to think off the top of my head, and that I won't go on to try to list, but definitely think about it and look into it. There's a lot that you can really benefit from if you take advantage of. So that's key takeaway number four. Number five's coming right up. It's my favorite. I'm gonna chill out here for a little bit longer, and then I'll give that to you and we'll wrap things up. Out here exploring this trail I found right now before headed back to the apartment, and just thought it'd be a good time to give you my fifth and final key takeaway from my freshman year of college, and that is to tap into your faith. If you don't have faith in yourself, if you don't believe in yourself and where you're going, then you're not gonna go anywhere. It's not gonna go where you want it to lead to. So that's key, but that's not what I mean when I say to tap into your faith. That's not the point I wanna get across with this. Really, wherever you are on the spectrum, whether you don't believe in God, you're an atheist, you're not sure, you do, but you have questions,
unanswered questions, you've had a bad experience, or you do believe in God, or you do consider yourself a follower of Christ, wherever you are, I believe that college is the perfect time to really seek God with an open heart, really explore your faith, find out who Jesus really is and what that really means for you. And really, as college students, we are in a pivotal season of our lives. We're making decisions that will impact the trajectory of our lives forever. And we're not making decisions that do the same thing. And that sounds like some big thing, but really it comes down to the little decisions, the small beginnings, the everyday things. And for me personally, I can tell you that the best decision I've made in college, and actually my entire life, is to do this, is to tap into my faith, to seek God with an open heart, to learn about Jesus and what that means for me. And I won't get into my whole testimony. That's a whole another video, because I could go on and on and on. But I will say, personally, through it, I found my identity. It's been the answer to all my problems. It's allowed me to find peace. It showed me how to walk in purpose. And it's exposed the lies of culture in this world that I've been oblivious to and that I believed for so long. And I'm believing that for you, if you decide to do this, if you decide to start wherever you feel inclined to start, tap into your faith, whatever you feel inclined to do, read that devotional, crack open that Bible, go to that church service, join that group, pray that prayer. It's all small beginnings. Whatever you feel inclined to do, the Bible says, seek and you will find. So that's what I'm believing for you. And I'm believing that it will be the best decision for you as well, is to just tap into that, just explore that. And that's point number five. That's my favorite one right there. That's what I'm most passionate about. I'm not trying to push religion on anyone. It's not religion for me. It's a relationship with Jesus. But that can be another video, but that's my favorite one right there, and I think that's a great one to end it off on. And I'm so grateful for you watching this whole video, making it to the end of this video. It's awesome. I'm gonna start making more of these. I hope this video served you. I hope it was valuable to you. I hope you got something from it that stuck with you, that you're able to take and apply to your life and to make your college experience a better experience. That's what this is all about. But just know that you are capable. More videos on the way, and I'll see you in the next one.
Peace. Okay, go, go, go. She always be talking like she no. I told her don't ever leave me long. I guess I'm accident. Wrong.